What I will try to do is when I begin taping, if I have a reason for taping that, I will tell you. So in this case, the reason is it's the Galena Pass, and I'm going to go a lot of twisties. It's radio's off. This is probably some of the better driving video that you'll see. The RPMs are high, but I'm not going, like, I'm going 70 now, but that's not near what this car can do, so the only thing that concerns me is a little bit of water like that. That's a lot of water, and I'm in third gear. Oh my god, this is fucking awesome. A lot of snow. So this will be about a 8-minute video because I'm going to go all the way to the top, to the down, and back. Actually, it's probably going to be like 15. So, you know, there's a part that I think is really beautiful at the summit. So, otherwise, this is all just for me to relive. If you want to scrub forward and see what the summit is like, I think it's also pretty cool that there's still snow here. I'm curious how it sounds with the wind. I mean, it's like it's on rails. It's not even close to its limit. Really, all I'm scared about is wildlife at this point. And actually, it's getting cold, so I'm gonna close the windows. I really don't care for the placement of the windows. Oh my god, it really is. Blocks out all the noise. So I'm not going. In both of my other cars, I've gone significantly faster around here. For whatever reason, I feel like I'm scared, rightfully so, because the cost of a fucking up is that much more. I mean, I'm going 50 miles an hour now, and I've gone through here in both my other cars, all my other cars, in 70 or 80, I'm going 60 now. I think because that engine is just so, it's not angry, it's just, it is intimidating. It's just, if the engine makes you feel like you're going much faster than you are, 60 miles an hour, and it just makes driving so much more visceral. I mean, you know, although it has all the driver aids, what do they call it when something is, I forget, there's a word. Oh my god. That's where the window's up. I'm just shocked at how slow I'm going and how fast I feel like I'm going. That's the case in my 911. You don't have to go so fast to feel like you're going fast. And this is kind of, here we're getting to the peak. So we cover the lens and then uncover it. but you just feel like it's going to just, oh my God, it's just, I can't describe it. Again, it's just very odd. I'm going 60 miles an hour, and just let you know, a skilled driver can easily go do what I did at over 90. And this is not terribly far from my house. It's probably 35 minutes to get to this road. So, and you know, most people have to go an hour on the drive just to go nowhere, work or traffic. And this is, I complain about driving 30 minutes to experience this. I mean, look at this. I mean, this is just insane. And again, what's bizarre is how incredibly stable it is. And I am told the back can get squirrely if you want to let it, and it'll come back and make sure you don't fuck up. So now we are at the, holy shit. I'm gonna get out and take a picture. Okay, so sorry. I should no, I gotta get behind that car. So I'm gonna go down the pass and turn around and come home. Alright, let's get this. I am in auto. I am out of auto. I think I'm recording. And first, second year. And here's the key, the steering wheel has a light on it that will tell you when you're in the higher rev zones, like a race car. Oh my God. And it actually lets you have a little more fun because you feel like you're going a lot faster than you really are. But so I'm going 51 now, and oh my God, that's just amazing. And I live here, and I'm going on a ride that's going to have just nothing but equally beautiful. I think the key is to keep these revs in that range, in the 6,000 range, and not feel like it's too much. Light is a little screwy. If I felt comfortable driving this, I would. What I'd like to be able to do is drive the line, not just me in my lane. That would help immensely. That's how they help you at the racetrack. You drive the entire road. It's not. So even just doing that sound, that kind of scared me, but it shouldn't. That's the way the car's supposed to behave. When you downshift it. To, you know, driving it not just as a grand tour, you know, but also as a race car, right? You know, a 12-cylinder, 690 horsepower, you know, Ferrari that can do this. So, like, I pushed and put my foot on the brake to go into this. That there's no reason that's going 60 miles an hour. I mean, this could do 95 through that. I don't like being stuck in my lane. I think I need to kind of this is the first time I've really taken the car out and ridden it. You know, up until now, I've been scared of it. I've been getting all my seat technology sorted, you know, just figuring shit out and, you know, getting nervous about, you know, what was up. You know, looking at my phone, sharing it with people. Now, I'm just driving it to have fun. Completely unscheduled. Okay, so I'm going to turn around and head back up. Turn the video camera on and off. And there's the turnaround up there. So, oh my God. Try to do a launch control. So I'm gonna start another video.